Next, a high school musical set in the 50s, released in the 70s, and four decades on, we still know all the dance moves.
I think Grease is the perfect dance film from start to finish. I got chills,
they're multiplying. You're the one that I want. We see the transformation of Sandra turn into Sandy.
Olivia Newton-John in that black suit and him coming up in that black tee, it's hot and sexy. You better shape up.
They literally had to sew me into those pants in the morning. So I couldn't drink a lot, of course, because I didn't ever have to pee in the middle of the day.
Well, John and Olivia, they loved each other a lot, and I think John had a big crush on Olivia. She liked him a lot. She was married. She had a nice husband at the time, but John, he was mad for her.
There was a great chemistry between us, and thank goodness, because it really worked for the role.
That's Grease Lightning!
Danny and Sandy bought the romance, but the film's most famous dance moves were driven by pure testosterone.
I want everyone who's watching tonight to stand up if they haven't gone Go Grease Lightning. And I'll bet no one stands up.
It lends itself to sort of Elvis Presley, you know, in that there's the hand gestures that Elvis used to get away with, the hip thrusting.
It was pretty raunchy stuff, and it was a celebration of sex in a car. Great American pastime, sex in the back seat.
Go Grease Lightning, you're crossing through the heat lap. No, sorry, do it again.
It was up, and it was out, and then the other hand came across.
In, up, in, out. You are spring, the chicks are cream. Go Grease Lightning. How can anyone make such a silly move so sexy? But John Travolta could.
I spent almost 17 years working with Michael. He was this energy that when you knew him off camera, he was very quiet and shy. But when he got in front of that camera, it was like he stuck his finger in the electric socket and his body became dance.
30 years on, the thriller routine continues to inspire new generations, from flash mobs to weddings.
My favorite bit is this head movement here.
Still to this day, I don't think there's an artist like Michael Jackson. He's timeless.
I think Thriller is still as famous as it is because no one's ever been able to beat it, and I think nobody ever will.
Well, that's where you're wrong, Marcia, because we're about to reveal the dance moment that ITV viewers voted as their number one. Have you guessed what it is? In 1952, Gene Kelly choreographed and starred in the film that for many remains the greatest musical ever made.
This California dew was just a little heavier than usual tonight.
Really? From where I stand, the sun is shining all over the place.
Singing in the Rain, without doubt, is my favorite musical of all time. He's fallen in love, head over heels, and nothing else in the world matters. That's how love makes you feel, encapsulated in a dance.
I'm singing in the rain, just singing in the rain. What a glorious feeling.
Gene is wonderful. The song is wonderful.
I'm laughing at clouds so dark up above.
Gene had a way of showing happiness because he was an athletic person and he could move with great feeling of freedom and expression by the way he danced and moved.
Come on with the rain, I have a smile on my
walk down the lane with a happy refrain.
Gene Kelly had the ability to turn a prop into another human being. An umbrella, as he holds it, you can imagine that's his woman.
I'm happy again.
This legendary scene took director Stanley Donen 3 days to shoot and was fraught with difficulties.
People often say to me, that must have been a lot of fun to make that movie. I say, are you out of your mind? I mean, it's nothing but complication. We shot it on the MGM street, and in Culver City in the warm days, in the afternoon, people watered their lawns, and we lost enough pressure on the water that we couldn't shoot after 3 or 4 o'clock in the afternoon.
The first time I saw Singing in the Rain, I must have been about 7 years old. And he's probably one of the reasons I first started dancing.
In 2008, more than 14 million viewers watched George perform the street dance version of Singing in the Rain that won him the second series of Britain's Got Talent.
For about 3 minutes of my life, I felt incredible. And I can imagine that's how Gene Kelly probably felt most of his life.
More than 50 years on from when it was first released, Singing in the Rain remains as popular as ever, and it's now, officially, the nation's favourite dance moment.
Singing in the Rain, I mean, genius.
It's one of those things that people are just never going to forget. Something that will live on for years and years to come.
Everybody likes to splash water. It's what we did in Charlton. When you've seen it, you want to go out and dance in the rain.
I don't think you can be a dancer and not like Singing in the Rain.
It was just amazing how that beautiful scene can make you feel happy all of a sudden for no reason.
If you don't like Singing in the Rain, get a life. There's something wrong with you.